always a good time when these two nations go head-to-head. That's exactly what we're going to get this week. The Rivalry Series presented by TCF Bank begins right here on NHL Network tonight, where we'll see Team USA and Team Canada go head-to-head in the first of three games over the next week. Puck drop for tonight goes at 7 o'clock Eastern, and what better way to get you set for this game than by chatting with the coach of the Americans, Bob Corkum. Bob, first of all, how you doing? You expecting a big crowd for this game in London or what?
Absolutely. It's supposed to be filled to the brim, and we're expecting the same thing in Toronto, and certainly looking very much forward to getting back to Hockey Town USA on Sunday to play the matinee in Detroit.
Yeah, that should be a lot of fun in Detroit. Looking forward to that finale with all those fans in the big building there. I want to ask you about the difference with coaching men and coaching women. You played in the NHL for a long time. You got to coach. You were at the Honors. You coached at Maine. But now you're coaching the women's team. What's the difference for you?
I'd say there's more similarities, really, than differences. As far as a difference, I think the women are more coachable. They seem to really want to learn. They show up and they're just sponges. They want to be corrected constantly, and that's very different than the men's side of games. I think having been a player myself, you tend to blame people a little bit more and pass the buck. At least they did during my days, but I'd say that's the biggest difference.
It was an amazing month for Kendall Coyne. She came on the scene and dominated the skills competition in San Jose, and today she was named captain. I'm wondering what makes her a special leader and the perfect person to be captain of your team.
Certainly she has the character, and she's been through the program. She's grown with the program. She's a great leader on the ice, off the ice, and she's just a go-to person in every way that we need her. We certainly have a lot of those leaders on the team. The team voted, and they chose her, and it's a great honor, and one that she'll represent very well, I'm sure.
Well, I got to find out where you were when she competed in the skills competition and what you thought when you saw her take that lap and do so well, and the reactions from all of the guys, I think, said a million words.
Oh, absolutely. It was wonderful. I watched it live, and she was absolutely flying around there. I was just hoping she wasn't going to catch an edge and go flying into the boards, but she can certainly wheel, and you know, the response she got from the guys was exceptional. It's just been great for women's hockey, and this is just another step towards that, this rivalry series, and it should be a great one.
Well, in more and more recent years, we've seen players in the NHL come from non-traditional hockey markets. You think of Austin Matthews from Scottsdale. Is that starting to come into the women's game, where not every girl's from Michigan, Minnesota, or Massachusetts?
Absolutely. I think I noticed it mostly at the younger age levels. I was out recently in L.A. Doing a little scouting before they went on to their world championships in Japan. And a lot of those players are from Texas. Hannah Belk is from Texas. So some of those areas are starting to come in. Florida is starting to produce a lot more players. And it's great. You know, obviously the hockey, both the men's side and the women's side, is continuing to grow. And it's just wonderful.
Yeah, every time the Olympics comes around and we see Canada and the U.S. in the women's game face each other, I think it does amazing things for the game. So for anyone watching right now that maybe has never watched the women play, we got the game coming up 7 o'clock Eastern right here on NHL Network. Bob, tell the people at home that have never watched these two nations go head-to-head what kind of hockey they can expect tonight.
It's going to be fast, exciting, in-your-face hockey. I know there's no checking, but there's plenty of bumping and grinding, and the women absolutely sell out every single shift, and they give everything they have. And obviously, we love to play Canada. They love to play us. I think we each bring out the best in each other, and you just never know what's going to happen. You're going to end up on the right side sometimes, on the wrong side sometimes, but it's great for hockey, and it's a lot of fun for everybody involved.
Yeah, it's usually dramatic, and there's always a lot of passion on display. By the way, anyone that might want to get tickets to the game in Detroit, there are still seats available, so you can look into that online. That game is Sunday in Detroit, so if you want to go, there are still tickets available. Bob, thanks for this, and good luck tonight, sorta.
Thank you very much.
Good luck, Bob.
Have a good night.
See ya.